So we have some pretty interesting news that just dropped from Rob Domofsky. He tweeted, here's a bit of a surprise. The Packers are releasing 2020 fifth round pick Kamal Martin, a source said. So with the Packers having to get down to 80 players during this week, they're going to release five more players. I honestly just did not expect Kamal Martin to be one of the guys they would release, at least this week. Last week I did make my 2020 prediction or 2021 roster prediction, and I predicted he wouldn't make the roster just because the fact that Oren Burks and Ty Summers have both looked really good, sort of so far this preseason, plus their special teams ability. And I was sort of talking about the fact that the Packers had, you know, been using Kamal Martin at outside linebacker a little bit. I was just sort of saying and thinking to myself, you know, why are they using him at outside linebacker unless they, like, don't think, you know, he is going to, you know, have a role as the middle linebacker? Because if he, you know, has a role as the inside linebacker, why would you be trying him at outside linebacker unless you think maybe he won't have a role there? So I didn't expect them to release him this early, and I was honestly even a little, I said in my video, I was like, this is probably one of the ones where I'm the most, you know, nervous about being right or not. But apparently the Packers are actually going to release him. Honestly, just didn't see it coming. It's sort of crazy to think that, you know, a year ago he was starting for the Packers, and just 1 year later, he is no longer going to be on the Packers roster, not even making the top 80 players on the Packers roster, which is pretty crazy. I was taking a look at his grades in the two preseason games from PFF. And if we take a look at defensive grades for all the players that played in the past two preseason games for the Packers, he has the second to last worst grade by PFF. He is ranked 30th of the defense. Only person behind him is Will Redman, who's only played 9 snaps. But Kamal Martin has played in 27 snaps this preseason. He has a 39.9 grade, which is, you know, obviously not very good at all. And he allowed, let's see, he only has 3 tackles in the preseason, and I think he allowed a few receptions. Because there were a few plays last game in the preseason game where he sort of seemed to be struggling a little bit. Wasn't really getting over to cover the guys who are out there. So apparently the Packers don't think he has a future here. Not even, you know, top 80, which is honestly pretty crazy. I still sort of was wondering if he was going to make the roster or not. But I guess that also sort of shows how much the Packers, you know, have faith in the guys they do have there, if they're willing to release a guy that was starting last season. Of course, we got Devondre Campbell in this offseason, a veteran guy who's going to be a starter, as well as Chris Barnes, who started last year alongside Kamal Martin. Then outside of him, of course, we have Oren Burks and Ty Summers, who I think have shown, you know, a lot so far this preseason. So I think the fact of those two guys, you know, playing pretty well, and then Kamal Martin seemingly not doing as well, he was dealing with an injury, I guess that's why they're deciding to move on with Kamal Martin. But I'm honestly curious to sort of hear what they have to say about it. Maybe in the next couple days the Packers will have, you know, one of those interviews, press conferences, and maybe they'll explain a little bit more about the, you know, exact reasoning for releasing Kamal Martin. I'm also curious to see if, you know, any other team is going to come in here and say, oh, maybe Kamal Martin could actually be good. Because he did look pretty good at times last season. He didn't play, you know, I guess quite as much as Chris Barnes, but I thought there were lots of times last season where he was flying around and looked really good, and I thought maybe he had a future here in Green Bay. But apparently, he does not have a future. So I wish him nothing but the best wherever he does end up, if he ends up on another team, sometime this season. But definitely interesting news. If you guys haven't subscribed, you want to see Packers content, Packers news, all comes out on this channel pretty much, you know, 1 to 2 times a day. So make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. But that's it for now, and I'll see you guys on the next video.